Okay. So, nobody's around and it's already night. Let's just go over here and immediately read this. Dan! Big news! Got a call from Bracket Books in Eugene, and they want you to do a reading from Windsong. Maybe even some Q&As, some more book signings, all that good stuff. I think you should do it. In fact, I'm gonna be pretty pissed if you don't. Bracket is a big outlet. So if this goes well, orders for the new book will definitely go up. I don't need to remind you how long it's been since Tremor's Way came out. If you don't keep your name out there, then no one will even notice when you finish the new book. Whatever it's called. Hell, speaking of the new one, why don't you just read some of it too? Maybe the second chapter you sent me last month. That one was pretty good. Bracket Books, Eugene, the 21st. See you there. Paul. P.S. You know the long game, right? Nailing this one could be a mean a bigger advance on the next book. Okay, what? Why is Paul? Paul has both written me and called me, and I don't really understand why.
I just got off the phone with Mom. She told me about Grandma Jo.
Nope.
I know we expected it sooner rather than later, but this is hitting me so much harder than when Granddad died last year. Do you remember going to Grandma Jo's house after school on Wednesdays and playing until Mom got off work? How Grandma Jo always had a surprise for us, even if it was just cookies in the oven. She'd always time it so the whole house would smell like them when we got there. I hope the minister captures those little moments because they don't seem as little now. I wish the circumstances were different, but it will still be good to see you at the funeral. What am I saying? You probably won't even get this until after the funeral. I guess I just needed to write anyway. Love, Linda.
I really like the attention to detail there and the voice acting. Because like you can kind of hear like a half crying sound to the voice. Mark the 21st of this month on your calendars. For one day only, watch the world famous Fighter Five as they scream across the sky. Witness death-defying feats of flying in a display unlike anything you've ever seen. Guaranteed to blow you away. Don't miss it. Hey, let's get back in a lamp. Ooh, I'm a lamp. Oh, the bucket's gone. It's just over there now. I hear somebody. Yeah, well, kid, you don't get everything you fucking want. I don't care if you want a new plane. You want a plane up in heaven?
I'm sure she is.
Is she in heaven?
I'm sure she is.
Is she in heaven?
Yep. Telling the kid more little light lies. Grandma Joe is in hell, son. Alright. Did you know Grandma Joe liked to, I don't know. What's something horrible Grandma Joe did? Not betting on the ponies. That doesn't take you to hell. Grandma Joe had tattoos all over her. The Bible forbids that, right? Yeah. She's in hell. She had tattoos.
Oh.
We need to
How's
get.
my little man doing?
Man, everyone is downstairs now. Okay, well then let's go upstairs and look for clues.
Most of you here knew my grandmother. For those who didn't, I truly wish you had. She was an example for all of us. Her warmth, her caring, and her smile were impossible to forget. It's still hard for me to believe she's gone. Without her, the world is.
I kind of feel like.
Hey, Mom.
Oh.
Here we go.
Like, it's not that I don't feel for the characters, but I feel like maybe there should have been another day or something, in between the funeral just to let us get to know them a little bit better. Because at this point, it feels kind of superficial. Like,
Oh no. Joe's funeral's the same day as the signing in Eugene, and Paul says they can't move it. He'll understand if I bail because he knows Linda, but Grofield is a different story. They won't give a damn why I missed it. They'll just get a memo and put it in a spreadsheet somewhere and write me off just a little bit more. And it's not just the timing. If I do the reading, I've got to get that chapter in shape. It's not even remotely ready for anyone to see it. Can't worry about what Paul says. He's my agent. He's supposed to stroke me. And what about Tommy?
Yeah, that's exactly the same as last time. Tommy wants to go to the air show. Kid, you are predictable as all hell. Okay, there's the shell.
Why does it keep doing that?
I don't know, kid. Why does it keep doing that? You're definitely not an asshole.
Why'd it do that? Here we go.
Tommy, your parents don't hate you, but you are a little bit needier than I think you need to be. Oh, wait, there's something there. Okay, Linda, just go start painting. Thank you.
I walked out to the bluff to remember Grandma Jo and say goodbye. And on the way back, I started thinking about what it really means to have a family. To make that your focus. She seemed to take such joy in being surrounded by her family, providing for them, taking care of them. I hope I never took that for granted. When I got back to the house, a question hit me that I can't get out of my head. What will Tommy think about Dan and me when he gets older? And what if Tommy has kids of his own? Mm-hmm. I can't even begin to think of myself as a grandmother. I haven't even been a mother for that long, and I'm still feeling my way through what it means to be a good one.
Okay.
At least I'll always have an example. I miss you, Grandma Jo. And I'll never forget you. I promise.
Yeah, I know. I know you. I know. Let's go into your memories. Memories. Nothing ever happens in the bathroom. Except for shit! I am funny ghost. What do you have to say?
We just got back from the show, and I still don't know how I feel about it. The turnout was okay, and I did sell a piece. I learned a long time ago to never complain about selling anything, no matter how small. So that's good, no matter what. But part of me also feels like the glass was half empty. The promo was okay, but I think the abstract layout was a little too weird for the paper. I really should have gone with more text. Then again, it was good of Dan to have helped with that part at all, so who knows how bad it would have been without that. I guess I was most excited to see what kind of feelings the show would bring back up, and it was just too half-hearted to know. Disappointment and excitement in equal parts. I still have some thinking to do.
Mm-hmm. Oops, I didn't mean to go back in. Okay, Tommy, no, Tommy, stop following your dad around. Shouldn't you be in bed?
That might work. Kaplan, I'm so sorry. Tell me what I can do.
Just be here for me.
I don't know how I'm going to make a compromise here. Like, I really don't.
Explain before he started in on me, reamed me out, absolutely killed me. No point writing any more than that. Writing everything here instead of working on the book is what screwed me in the first place.
Okay, but again, like, why don't you just...
That might work.
Yeah, Tommy, yeah, you're... Definitely, Tommy is not. Wait, what's that? I'm sure that you would love to go to a spaceship show thing, but no. Dan needs to work on his shit. So I'm sorry, but that's the way it is. Now, let's find out more about this house. Okay, so Linda is definitely going to call. We're not going to the air show. There's a funeral to go to. I'm sorry, kid, but there's a friggin' funeral to go to. From the desk of Harold Baxter. A final entry before I depart. The bank would no doubt prevent me from purchasing the house due to inherent conflict of interest, but given its history of frequent ownership changes, I feel confident that the mortgage department will be glad to have the property off their hands. I believe I could set up a trust, or perhaps a shell company, and convince Mr. Lowry that we must part with the property for less than market value. I feel certain I can appeal to his conservative nature. I believe it will prove to be a shrewd investment as a rental property, and I think I now understand why people do not stay for extended periods. I find myself unable to describe the feeling precisely, but in my time here I've found my mind drifting in strange ways, as if it's not always my own. But the natural beauty is undeniable. Perhaps shorter visits are wiser use of this property. Yes, I believe that is a fine idea. Indeed. There's usually two books. Nothing to read on toilet. I don't know why I love that accent, but I love it. It's so stupid. But all characters must sound like this. Now, Tommy, so fast. Yeah, Tommy, well, tough luck. Or if we're in the toilet, tough shit. Ha ha ha, I'm a funny ghost. I made another funny. Oh, there it is over here. Diary of Claire Bradford. We're here, so why don't I feel more excited? This is supposed to be fun, just Roger, me, and me. Mom and Dad think we're here with Ben and Lori, but of course, that was just a trick. No, just Roger and me in this big house by the ocean for the whole week. I'm sad to see there's no piano here. But I suppose a week without practice won't do me much harm. I guess maybe being alone with Roger for that long is what's making me feel nervous. But why should it? He's my fiancé, after all. I'm supposed to spend the rest of my life with him. I shouldn't be worried about spending the week with him, should I? Everyone has second thoughts before getting married, right? So, I'm trying to place when this game is taking place. All the phones are rotary phones, and there's a typewriter. But, like, nothing feels particularly one decade or another. I really want to know what decade. Is this the 70s? Like, that's the only thing that feels like anything. Is his mustache feels very 70s. Dan knew his books had drifted almost completely out of the public eye, and he couldn't turn down the chance to get his work back into the literary spotlight. He drove to Eugene on the 21st and was surprised to see a line at the door for Bracket Books. Paul had delivered. Dan wasn't completely happy with the chapter he read, but the crowd certainly seemed like it. He left Eugene with a confidence boost that carried him for days. He knew he couldn't ignore Grandma Jo's passing completely, though, so he flew into Denver the night before the funeral and attended the visitation. He was on the ground for less than 12 hours before having to fly back out, and Linda was hurt that he didn't go to the services at all as well, but she knew he was trying to make the best of a difficult situation. When Dan told Tommy they wouldn't be able to go to the show, Tommy had a crying fit and tried to tear up the magazine. It worried his parents. He hadn't thrown a fit like that in almost a year. Exactly the kind of thing they'd hoped to avoid by spending the summer in such a quiet, peaceful place. You take a kid to a quiet, peaceful place, he's gonna have fits. He's not gonna have things to do. And that's how the Kaplan's first month at the house in the cliff came to an end. Oh, okay. Dan sent a work in progress to his agent, who was glad to see that Dan had gotten back on track. They were both hopeful that Dan could maintain his focus and write a book that delivered on the promise of his work so far. Oh, this might be the end, actually. I wonder. The next day, Dan made good on a promise to take Tommy into the woods and look for arrowheads, though he barely had the time. Tommy could tell his father was disinterested, but once he found an arrowhead, his spirits improved a bit. Dan waited while Tommy explored, but he didn't join in. Shortly after Tommy found a lone arrowhead, they returned home. A few nights later, Dan and Linda got a babysitter and drove into town for a date. They spent more than they should have on a bottle of wine and had a good time, but they didn't notice everyone else leaving. When they finally realized they were the last ones to the restaurant, they apologized and left, giving their waitress a generous tip. They still had 2 more months on the coast, and their story was just beginning. Okay, I was gonna say, it's like, that seems like a really weird point to end things. Full house. A friend of Dan's was coming to visit, but someone has turned off a few lights in the house. Lights have been turned off, cannot be possessed. Of course. Apparently I'm an electrical spirit. I did not know this. I didn't think this game was going to take this long, but I guess it is. Guy, probably not expecting to hear from me, were you? You know, I'm all about surprises. Who the fuck is Guy? Or is it Gog? It's not much better. Or Gug? Look, we're gonna have to head up the coast. We're gonna head up the coast next weekend. We're doing the drive from LA to Seattle. So we are on the West Coast. Even though it really feels like Maine. Maybe this is taking place like nearby to Life is Strange or something. I'm gonna interview up there on Tuesday, and Kelly has a friend who's gonna introduce her to some casting people from Vancouver. Can we crash at your place on the way up? We should be pulling through next Friday. I was thinking we could use it as an excuse to jam on our books. I want to see your new stuff, and I have a draft I want you to take a look at. I'm way beyond knowing what's good or not with my work, so I could really use your advice. And, you know, I'll give it to you straight about your new book. Is there a title yet? Could be an impromptu writer's workshop, I guess. Anyway, I think it'd be fun. Just let me know. T. Okay. Is there anything over here? No. Honey, sorry it's been so long since my last letter, but we've been all over the place. Have you gotten settled into that big house yet? I hope getting away from everything has been a help for you and Dan. I'm writing because, speaking of getting away, your father and I are going to take a road trip. I found some good AARP deals, and your father only working part-time, it isn't very hard to arrange time off. It's been too long since our last trip. I've always enjoyed changes of scenery, and as you're hopefully learning, it can just be the thing a marriage needs. Lord knows it helped us. The trip won't take us close enough to the shore to come visit, but I'm sorry to say, and if you write back, we'll be long gone before your letter arrives. We'll call if one of our motels has long distance. But if we don't get a chance to call, send my love to Dan and Thomas. You know, your father and I want the best for you all. When is this? That does feel like a very old TV. Okay. Not TV. Fridge. So, who turned off the fucking lights? Why is that memory sound?
I thought Tommy was sleeping with us.
Okay, he is saying with.
I'm checking to see if this is a foldout.
You know what the best way to check if it's a foldout? Try and lift it. If it feels like you're lifting something incredibly heavy, it's a foldout. Or some sort of recline, like just an insane amount of recliner crap. Oh, there's the other. You have a book?
Going to the funeral alone was hard. There's a part of me that understands why Dan couldn't come, but I don't think I'll ever get over him not being there. What would Grandma Jo have thought? She probably would have had the perfect advice, something like what she used to say about living a balanced life, not just a balanced week.
Yeah, exactly.
Dan coming to the visitation did at least make it a little more bearable. I have to give him that.
Linda Jo would probably have said, or Grandma Jo would probably have said, Linda, that I'm just going to be dead. You don't have to come to the funeral. Go with Dan. But maybe Grandma Jo was really religious or something. Man, that picture of Tommy and his dad is always, 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 always in Tommy's memories. I think we gotta do a Tommy thing today.
Can Davey sleep over?
The fuck is Davey?
Let me call his mom.
How do you have friends out here in the middle of nowhere? I'm still really confused as to when the fuck this is. Check sofa. Call Chamber of Commerce. Hotels in town. Double check D&K trip when Dan gets back. Watch that ugly sweater Mom and Dad gave me so they can see me wearing it. I didn't think your Mom and Dad were coming here. So why can't I go into lamp? The lamp isn't off. Or maybe it is, and it's just really bright anyway. That's really kind of weird. Okay. I'm assuming this is... Man, kid, you... Okay, read Tommy's thoughts to see what he wants. Where are you, Tommy? We can use the blue sheets to make a sofa fort. That is accomplishable. We can make a sofa fort.
Good news. Mom called today with a change of plans. They made better time on the first leg of the
trip okay.
than they expected, and they're coming to visit. Bad news, they want to come this weekend. Did Dan tell Tynan they could stay here for sure, or is that still up in the air? I'll ask after dinner.
We're telling Tynan no.
On the phone, though I can't help
Tynan sounds like a jerk.
This trip because they hit another rough patch. I hope not. I hope they just want to see Tommy and have a classic Mears family feast. Though, maybe seeing how they've ended up will be good perspective for Dan and me. Speaking of which, Dad better not get nosy. I've told him a million times that my marriage is not his business. Maybe I'll try the thing Christine told me. When someone asks you something private, just say, "Why do you ask?" Put it back on them and see if they've actually got a reason to get into your business. Yeah, I've got to remember to try that. We'll see how he answers that one.
Oh, there is a note right here. Oh, no, don't flicker.
Light again? Oh,
damn it.
I'm gonna need to call about that one.
I'm gonna need to call about you. I don't understand why I can only use... Okay. I don't know. Oops. Crap.
You can sleep with us.
What about Tommy? What about Tommy?
So, both of them are remembering the kid sleeping with them. Good to know.
Still can't believe how many people showed up at the reading. Maybe I haven't faded into obscurity just yet. But forget about the publicity. That's fleeting. Won't matter in the end. The best thing was having a deadline and hammering on that chapter. I think I finally evened out the voice, and I think Scott's backstory is finally settled. Never underestimate the motivational power of potential public humiliation.
They need another bed for someone to sleep in because they're pissed. Like, either way, Dan's friends are visiting, or Linda's parents are visiting, and there's only two beds in the house, and it's not a full-out coach, so I'm guessing that basically, because I'm guessing, do Linda and... No, they might have a slightly bigger bed, but I think the point is that Tommy is supposed to sleep with them because, oh shit. Hey, you should make your wife breakfast in bed.
I took Tynan up on the book jam. He hasn't seen a word of my new book, and fresh eyes are priceless. He bailed me out on Tramer's Way. I hope he understands how much of that book worked because of him. I still remember when we were walking to the pond, and he had the idea about using newspaper clips and police reports. Of course, no matter how many times I tell interviewers it was his idea, they just keep giving me the credit. Maybe they just want the tidy auteur version. Oh well, can't change that. Let's just hope he has an idea for this one, too. Freddy can't get here soon enough.
This is, I think, the hardest choice we have to making so far. No, that's Linda. Where's Dan? There he is. Okay, well, we need to help Tommy, no matter what. Tommy needs some help. Okay, so we need to use the blue sheets. So get the hell out of here, Tommy. That is one way. I feel like trying to balance everything, I'm just going to make everyone really unhappy overall. Like, I'm really trying to come up with, like, a balanced outcome, but I almost worry that it's just going to backfire and make everyone unhappy in the end. The Diary of Claire Bradford. Maybe getting my thoughts down on paper will help. Make a list. That's what Mom always taught me. So, dear diary, here are all the wonderful things about Roger. He's very handsome. He'll soon be working as a lawyer at his father's firm, although the job is no gift. He worked hard for it in college. He might be the only person on Earth who loves music as much as me. And he especially loves the songs I write him. His family has money. So realistically, Claire, the only thing that you really like about Roger is that he likes music and likes the music that you make. Okay, it's time for Dan to make a sacrifice this time. Because, Tommy made the sacrifice last time, and Claire had a really shitty run of things. So, you gotta find that fucking sweater. Also, I need to find another book. I'm pretty sure everything is just gonna end up terrible. I'm just driving everyone towards divorce, probably. Oh, I don't know why I feel like I can really get my thoughts together here. That's why this entry isn't going to be very fun, but fair is fair. Already waited a day, and there's no use in delaying it any longer. Here are the not-so-wonderful things about Roger. He can be so self-absorbed, especially when he's working on something. Kid. Yeah, come here. Come here.
Oh.
No one will ever accuse him of having a great sense of humor. He's so very predictable. Sometimes this makes me feel secure. Other times I just feel so damn bored. I wonder if maybe he spends too much time chasing his father and not being his own man. There, now I feel rotten. I do love him very much. Everyone has their flaws. Roger sounds like a dick. Maybe Claire killed Roger and shoved him down the toilet. Is this the ugly sweater that you somehow coincidentally have brought here? Okay. Also, the wine bottle is still here. Why is the wine bottle here? People don't clean up after yourselves. Dan knew how important it was for Tommy to play with friends his age, so he grabbed the sheets and gave Tommy a few tips on the finer points of structural engineering and sofa floor construction. When Davy came over, the two boys stayed up watching TV and eating ice cream far past their bedtimes, laughing and playing until they ran out of steam and passed out in the fort. Linda was glad they were able to make room for everyone, but with so much going on in the house, she didn't get as much time as she would have liked to visit with her parents. They were glad to be able to come at all, though. Linda didn't get a chance to pull her mother aside and see how her parents were doing. Linda, if you wanted your dad to not get involved in your marriage... Yeah. Dan hated missing a chance to get feedback on his book, and he found the company distracting. He tried to work through the commotion, but he never got into a rhythm. He couldn't even focus long enough to do small corrections. So instead of accepting the role of selfless host, he ran around doing weekend errands, not writing. Everyone looks kind of like slightly weird. Oh, Dan got a letter with some surprising I'm assuming this is the letter. No. Whether your whether your child enjoys arts and crafts, swimming, sports, recreation, singing, or exploring, they're sure to have a ball at Camp Emerald Lake. This sounds like a camp where everyone gets murdered. We know that every family has unique needs, and we strive to be as flexible as possible. Daily, weekly, and monthly packages are available in both sleepover and pickup options. Our lifeguards are carefully certified, and every counselor is trained in the cutting-edge cardiopulmonary resuscitation technique. So, CPR. Why would you not just say CPR? People are going to know what CPR means far easier than... Type faster game? I should play Typing of the Dead. That would be hilarious. I should. Do I have Typing of the Dead? I'm going to make myself a note. If I need to take a break from StarCraft, because we're going to be playing StarCraft for a while, I'm going to see if I can track down a copy of Typing of the Dead. Because, my God, that would be so funny. It's such a weird game. The enclosed brochure contains information on all the exciting opportunities at Camp Emerald Lake. We're sure you'll find many things to like, and we hope to see your child soon. Okay, so that's one Tommy clue. Assuming that's Tommy and Davey. Why do you guys keep moving the whiskey around on the counter? Oh, someone's coming. Oh, there's something on the table. There's something in here too I didn't see.
What about your rocket?
I already played with it.
Yeah, exactly. Dad, you don't have to play with rockets over and over again. Would you play with, like, the same toys over and over again? Now, where is Tommy coloring that picture? Because he's always coloring that picture. That's exactly what I said. Oops.
Hey, honey.
Hey, mommy.
Okay, she really wants to get out of the house. Okay, let's go upstairs. Since everyone decided to come downstairs, let's see what we can find upstairs. Hey, toilet. How's it going? I know it seems like things are going down the drain, but... Dan, I looked into it, and the guy at the literary register said that the pre-release ads do drive up pre-orders quite a bit. It's his job to sell ads, of course, so we have to take that with a grain of salt. I usually leave this kind of thing to the guys in the marketing department, so I'm a little out of my depth here, but I checked with them and they said the same thing. So it seems like ads would make sense, if the book is good. You don't want to oversell and underdeliver. I have to say, this is the first time I've had a writer offer to pay for extra marketing. You sure about it? There aren't any refunds if the book tanks. You've got some drive, though. Coming up with an idea like this? I'll give you that. Think about it and let me know. God. I could. But see, if I could capture that and have myself look like an idiot... I'm perfectly fine looking like an idiot for someone else.
Cut right through the pleasantries and ask you, who is this Ryan that Mom mentioned on the phone? Someone new? Are you trying to keep it a secret, or did it just slip your mind the last time we talked? Spill it. Things here are moving along, I guess. When we came up, I thought it would be great to have more dedicated time to paint, but I didn't realize it would be so isolating. I miss having more people around and having new ideas floating about. I got lucky in town last week, though. I found an artist co-op called Makeshift, and it seems really interesting. It's not too big, but there are lots of different types of artists there. I'll probably call and try to get more details. I don't remember if I told you this, but I've been thinking about going back to painting full time. Anyway, enough about me. Tell me what's up with you. Love.
Yeah.
I only met Rick once at a family reunion that must have been, 15 years ago? Turns out he made his fortune by, get this, selling high-end pipes. The Sherlock Holmes kind, not the plumbing kind. He must have been a hell of an interesting guy. I mean, he found a niche and made his way in the world. You have to respect that. It makes me wonder, am I giving everything I have to this book, or am I leaving myself an out? It isn't announced yet. I could always pull the plug. I'd never get another advance again, sure, but there isn't a gun to my head. Unless I put one there. Metaphorically, of course.
That got a little dark. Also, I was very happy that you pronounced niche right and didn't say niche. If he had said niche, I was gonna fucking flip the table or something. The goddamn writer, he doesn't say niche. Did you take Tommy out today? Maybe to the beach? I think you could both use some fresh air. I have to be in town by noon, and I probably won't be back till 4. And I am not an authority on Pee Wee Herman. I really did. Okay, so I really do not like Pee Wee. Oh fuck. Okay, you stop. Bop, bop. Really don't like Pee Wee Herman. Okay, so kid is kite. Okay, so there was more stuff downstairs, I think. Yeah. Here's the letter. Dan! I hope you're doing well. I got this address from your father. I hope it's correct. I'll get to the point. When your cousin Richard passed away last year, he discovered that his pipe business had done very well. He wasn't wealthy, but he was very comfortable. At the execution of his will, we were somewhat surprised that he wished to distribute his estate amongst all living blood relatives. He reserved the lion's share for his immediate family, as I'm sure you understand, but there was a portion allotted for you as well. Enclosed is a check for the full amount. I trust you will honor his memory by putting it to good use. Uncle Wayne. That's a little odd. Have I already gone into your memories? I can't remember.
There's something out there?
The entire world's out there.
What? Oh my god. That's a little passive aggressive.
I'm sure Mom and Dad would have liked to have been the only visitors in the house, but they understood the bad timing and were glad to see us at all. With so much going on, I didn't get a chance to talk to her about things with Dad. I need to try and call or write when they get back home. I hope they're okay.
Okay, painter bag. Okay, so I need to find more clues for Dan. I need to go into Dan's memory, that's the thing. Okay, I think Dan's upstairs. There he is.
And when I finish my book in December,
don't joke like that.
Is that all of Dan's? Yeah, I was gonna say. Look, Dan still has. Usually, everyone has two memories.
And as for last weekend. I can't stop wondering what kind of advice Tynan would have had for Act Two. It's still a mess. I tried to work on it, but it was impossible to get anything done with so much going on. Although I guess I did flex a little creativity. I came up with an impressive number of errands to run just to get out of the house.
Okay. Oops. I always forget that. Oh, shit. Into the lamp. I think advertising the book is a dumb idea. Let's not do that.
Anne.
Oh, wait. Oh, we already read this. I think you would be better off slowly working on your book and let Linda become a painter again. So, what we're going to do... Is everyone down here? Because I don't think we've looked at that painting yet. Oh. I want to look at that. And yet, everyone is here.
Why does he keep doing that? Why'd it do that, huh?
Oh, I'll put that on the list. You having a good day?
Uh-huh.
Maybe I did look at that already. Okay, well, you know what? Okay, so Linda is our primary priority. So where's her painter bag? I'm assuming her painter bag is in here. Yep. Okay. The daughter of Claire Bradford! Oh, God, Claire. I realize now that this isn't about Roger, it's about me. I have to decide who I want to be. Marrying Roger would set so many things in motion. We'll be a well-to-do couple, safe and secure, with wonderful friends and loving families. And I may slowly fade into be Roger's wife instead of Claire. But that'll be society's doing, not Roger's. He loves me too much to do that. Yeah, sure he does, Claire. But what about my music? If I'm accepted at Berkeley, I don't know what we'll do. I can't ask him to quit his job a month after he starts. What kind of couple lives in separate cities as soon as they get married? The decision can't be black and white, can it? Position and safety versus crazy pursuit alone? Is there a way to have it all? Do I even want it all? Will I ruin everything no matter what I choose? That is kind of how I feel, Claire. That seems to be the theme of this game, that balancing everything is fucking hard. And that maybe, hey toilet, maybe it's not possible. Hey look, look, I'm gonna make another shitty toilet joke, ha ha ha! Where is the, no, we're not doing that. The readers of Eugene and the surrounding area, judging from by the turnout, got a rare treat when author Dan Kaplan arrived for a combination reading and book signing. He shared a selection of his most recent work, still untitled and due in stores this fall. And if it was any indication, his fans are in for a real treat. Though the book isn't finished, Kaplan said that blah 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 blah. Okay, there's got to be another book around here somewhere. There it is. Hunter and I talked everything over today, and it was a mistake to speak so soon. I never should have brought up any of this without making up my mind first. Now I've only made things more difficult. I guess I was just daydreaming. And he asked me what was on my mind, and before I could help it, it just came all out. Though maybe I just wanted to get it off my chest. I told him I wasn't sure if it was the right time to get married, and it upset him badly. It didn't matter how many times I told him I wasn't calling it off, I had questions. That I hadn't made up my mind either way. All he heard was that I didn't love him anymore, which isn't true at all, but it didn't matter how many times I said that either. He's gone off for a drive, and now I'm here in the house alone. I think I've made up my mind. I hope he gets back soon so I can tell him. Okay, so, it's Tommy's, I don't want Dan promoting his book. I think Dan needs to be less hard on himself and say, fuck the advance. That's jerkish to do, but if we let Linda get back into painting and Dan be a better dad, and I think we're making some good choices also. Yeah. I swear this has moved. I'm going to move this slightly to this. There we go. Is that better? It's probably just all in my imagination. Now I'm just fucking with things pointlessly. There. Whatever! Let's see. Linda was thrilled when Dan told her about the inheritance money and offered to use it for the co-op instead of promoting his book. She started working 2 days a week in town, and it was all she hoped it would be. She made friends with a few local painters and learned new techniques from them, but simply being around creative people each week did her the most good. And Dan knew that while he couldn't also pay for Tommy to go to camp. It was important to him to have more playtime with children his age, so he called up Davy's parents and arranged regular playdates at the playground in town. He tried to make the trip himself as often as possible. It made a difference for Tommy. Dan decided not to place the ad, and deep down he felt like he was giving himself a vote of no confidence. It was subtle, but he knew regardless of the book's current state, he had apprehensions about being able to finish it the way he wanted, so he hedged his bets. He couldn't shake the lack of confidence for days, and his writing stumbled. So what? Your wife can be an amazing artist. Take care of your damn son. The bottle. Linda and Tommy were getting worried about Dan. Oh, great, I'm hitting the bottle. Assembly time, approximately 3 hours. Required tools, Phillips screwdriver, soft-faced hammer, socket wrench, recommended hex key. Town list. Go to library. Out of books again. Check community board for babysitter. Swing by the wild. New movie playing. Drop by Dr. Walker's. Call ahead. Of course you call ahead. Who the hell can make a dot while I guess in the States it's probably easier because of the whole... Tosh bags, aspirin, salad dressing, beer case, popcorn, Ogburn. What the hell's Ogburn? Seriously, what is Ogburn? Okay, well, Google did not help. I mean, beyond Ogburn was an American sociologist. He's known for his idea of cultural lag in society's adjustment to technological and other changes. Interesting. I wonder if that's like... It helps identify and explain social problems and predict future problems. Alright, well, let's go back in the lamp. I'm a fucking genie. All right. Toilet! Tickets are booked for Tahoe.
Can I see? It's not done yet.
Get out of the damn lamp, genie. Yeah, Dad's been drinking. I can't go into that lamp now, I guess. That one's off.
Alan. Hey, man. This is going to sound odd, but I could use some advice. I'm in hot water here because, well, I've been drinking more lately. Man, there's just no good way to write that. I mean, I used to drink and write all the time in school. You remember that, right? I guess I got away from it when we got married and definitely after Tommy came along. But... he's in bed by 8:30 every night now. And let me be clear. I'm not blacking out or driving drunk. You know I'd never do something like that. I just have a few drinks while I'm working, safe and sound in the house. A writer who drinks isn't exactly unheard of. Wow, could I sound more defensive? But here's the hell of it. It's working. It's brought back that college hunger, that energy. And in the last week or two, the book's just singing. I don't even know what I'm asking here. Maybe I just wanted to start the conversation. If you get a chance, give me a call. Dan.
I still find it very confusing that Paul wrote us a letter when, for the most part, he's been calling us. Yeah, it looks like Dad's having hangovers. Oops.
But he promised.
If he doesn't do it, I'll help you, honey.
Okay. Where is Tommy drawing? Is Tommy drawing again? Because he's usually drawing. Tommy! Oh, there he is over there. Okay, so Tommy wants his car put together, and I do not blame him. That thing is laying in the middle of the... Like, it's basically... He's left a mess. Dan has. Okay, Dan. There we go. Lana! Danger zone. So your memory is stubbing your foot on something because you're drinking. I do that all the time when I'm not drinking. I fucking run into shit all the time.
Should I have run the ad? I don't know if it would have helped the book, but I still spent all day kicking myself. Did I cop out? Is there some other reason why I didn't want to put the book out there yet? How am I supposed to believe I'm doing something that matters if I'm scared to tell the world about it? Damn it.
Okay, but the... Dan, you're annoying me. Oh, shit. I didn't think that was all of Dan's memory. Oh, it was. Okay. So Dan wants... Pour bourbon and work on the apartment scene. Which I'm sure will end, you know, just so well. Okay, I need you to leave, Dan, because I need... Yeah, exactly. Or sit down. Sitting down will work. Probably gonna take a break here after this day.
Write drunk, edit sober. Apparently Hemingway said that, or maybe someone else did. It doesn't matter, because it's true. To write, you have to be fearless. You have to make choices and plow forward. Surprise the reader, surprise yourself. Make something that matters, not something safe. What does drinking do? It suppresses inhibitions. Yeah, there are typos, but that's what copy editors are for, and it's not like I'm drinking all day. I'm fixing most of the stuff myself each morning. The afternoon, I guess. I'm not stumbling around drunk all day and pissing myself. I'm trying.
Yeah, but if you got getting hangovers regularly from drinking a glass while you're working,
the pressure's so bad I just want to give up sometimes. And those nights of drink is the only way to turn my mind off and get some sleep.
We are not doing what Dan wants to do this time. Because Dan, you're being an idiot and an asshole. I'm sorry, but like, get your fucking shit together.
I'm fine.
Why don't you stop at 2?
Exactly. You're not drinking more, Dan. Otherwise, if you keep visiting drinking, you're gonna have to visit Mr. Toilet. Oops.
Just got back from the co-op. What a day. Monica gave me an interesting idea for my ocean piece. The water will stand out more if none of the people on the shore have any blue on their clothes. I'm gonna work on that tomorrow. I'll be back here at the house, but just having new ideas and new friends makes working here so much more productive. I'm so glad Dan splurged on this. I can't wait to head back on Wednesday.
There's something on... No, I think I already read the thing on the door. Didn't I? Yeah. Oh, I bet you there's something... Wait. No, I did read that. I bet you there's... Oh, shit! In the bathroom.
Barb, I know I wrote yesterday, but I need your advice. I think Dan's drinking too much. And before you start to worry, let me say he's not an alcoholic. It's just because of the pressure he's under trying to finish the book. But you know Dan's never exactly been a health nut. He isn't gaining weight yet, though even that's just because alcohol kills his appetite. So he's hardly eating at night, which is another problem.
This is getting really depressing.
I don't think he sees what he's doing to himself, and I don't know how to break through to him about this. Sometimes I just want to say it's not like I have to get drunk to paint, but I know that's not the most mature way to handle it.
Also,
sorry for dumping all this on you. I just wanted to get it off my chest. Do you have any advice about how to talk to him? Yours, Linda. Oh, what if I...
Okay, so... we need to do what Linda wants. Okay, so we're gonna have to be very careful getting the fuck out of here. There. So yeah, Linda is first choice this time. Where is his jog... Where are his jogging shoes? Excuse me. Dude, are your shoes upstairs? Seriously? Is that where your shoes are? Yep.
Hey, you wanna go into town?
Okay. Okay, let's find out more about the house and choose the car. Well, we're going to choose the car immediately, because if we start in the living room, the car is, like, right over here. Yeah. Let's look for books. There's one in there. Diary of Kay Williams. Okay, so this is... We're still potentially in the 70s. Jay is gone and I am alone. That is the sum of it. Another thought enters my mind. Wed 38 years and now alone. A senseless accident has taken Jay from me. What should I do with myself? I don't know. Money is no worry. Time. That is the thing. There's so much of it still ahead of me. I've been blessed with health. But that blessing is now a curse. It's nothing more than the curse of time alone without Jay. I attempt to look ahead, but I cannot envision a path without Jay. For so long, I had to no need to imagine one. The children do not understand why I've come to this house alone. They cannot understand my loss. Well, that's depressing. Although I kind of find it strange that she or he didn't... I don't know. I cannot say that I feel better than I did upon arriving. Yeah, like, I find it strange that the names are blanked out, I guess. Jay is still gone, but I do feel change. Some glimmer of path is taking form in my mind. I cannot describe it other than the narrowing of thought. Perhaps time alone is to be thanked. Or maybe it's something else, something unknown. Today I drove to McLennan's to buy coffee, wine, and vegetables. Although I was not due to start short of the, run short of those for a few days more. I confess, I just went to hear human voices, to be around the living. I conversed with a pleasant couple, and it did me no small measure of good. My first words came out as a croak, and I realized I had not spoken in days. Small reminder of my solitary days here, alone with my thoughts, thinking of Jay, staring at the sea over the cliff. I must confess that my gaze always drifts from the sea to the edge of the cliff. Okay. That's foreboding. Hey, toilet. Oops. Making sure there's not more than two. There usually seems to be just two, but I'm gonna look. Okay. Why is she doing this? After talking with Linda, Dan realized how much his habit was hurting their relationship and his health. He started jogging every morning and quickly found that the runner's high wasn't a myth. In the week, he was getting an alarm to set off to get up early so he could run on the beach before breakfast. And while he sometimes missed the raw energy of reckless writing, he would have missed nights with Linda even more. When Dan still hadn't put the pedal car together, Linda stepped in and began working on it with Tommy. Dan heard them, felt a pang of shame with his regular hangovers, and came down to join in. They completed the project as a family. Although Tommy was hurt that it had taken so long for his father to help, he was finally happy to have his toy. Dan put all of the alcohol back in the kitchen cabinet and promised to stay dry on work days, but he had a hard time focusing while he adjusted to writing sober again. He spent a couple of evenings staring at a blank piece of paper, and he never told anyone how hard it was not to sneak down to the kitchen for a drink those first few nights. Oh. As July came to an end, the Kaplan's lives had developed a pattern. Dan finished his first draft, but instead of accomplishment, he felt disappointment. The book had gotten away from him. It was barely readable, much less publishable. Paul and Groverfield gave him one last chance to get it into shape. They didn't have to tell him what the consequences would be if he couldn't get it together. On Friday, Dan and Linda both knocked off early, took Tommy to his aunt's house, and drove to a bed and breakfast. But this is just their bedroom. They barely left the room. The guests in the room below complained about the noise, but the owner assumed Dan and Linda were on their honeymoon. Offered to move the guests to a different room instead. And on the following Tuesday, Tommy put on an art show in the den, explaining his drawings to his parents one by one. Dan made sure to ask questions and engage his son, who was more than happy to elaborate on his artistic intent. Dan and Linda clapped with each drawing, and by the end of the show, Tommy was beaming. Okay, so we need to focus more on Dan. They still had a month left, but Dan's chances to change the course of the summer were growing fewer. So we're going to take a break, and then we'll do the last month.